Yeah, like I said, sometimes I use drum software just. Sometimes I don't. I like. See, it always do. Now, it's not the most musical thing because you're just going straight up on a fret, but it's rhythmical. And so I turn it into a rhythm. I make it kind of fun instead of just an exercise going. But you play it slow to barely medium speed. You know, you don't have to go. You don't want to play it super fast because that's not going to help you be super fast when you're warm up or when you are warmed up. So. Here's the secret to it too. Do not stop. I'm stopping to tell you what I'm doing, but when I play these, I do not stop until that particular part is over. Fingers one and two, I don't stop till I go from first to 12th fret, then I stop. And a lot of times, I'll do the second, like one and two, then one and three, downward. So like. I've read online, and again, you know, sometimes the pundits take over. Oh, I don't start from the first fret. I start on the fifth. Or, oh, I don't do this and I do that. You play on the first fret. You play on the 12th fret. What I do is I don't start. Sometimes I'll start at the 12th fret. Sometimes I'll start downward on the first fret. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you play this continuously, and you play it in time, and you don't play it too fast. So after fingers one and three, one and four, then two and three. Now, when you get to one and four, just heard all those notes, but they were clean and they were articulate. And see, don't worry so much about your picking hand. You can do. Now I use alternate picking for this because I like to practice downstrokes. I've gotten more in tune with downstrokes. See, when I was younger, I never thought about it, so it's like. But as you know, YouTube, especially when you play Metallica, I mean, there's some great down pickers, or Mark Tremonti from Alter Bridge and Creed, he's great at down picking. So it's something that I've incorporated into practice as well. But anyway, when I do all these exercises and I play it slow, it takes about 10 minutes. So when you go through the whole thing, by the time you get to one and four, to. Then it's fingers two and three. Now, these exercises are in my Metal Method program. So anyway, I don't stop. The key is don't play it too fast. Play it super accurate. And do not stop until you have reached the end, which can be the 12th fret. But there's no law that says you can stop. You have to stop there. You can go 15th, 17th. But one of the things, too, is make it rhythmic. Don't just go down, 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 down. Like do 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 do. And see, because you're helping yourself, you're getting your whole mind and both hands. Yes! And so Robert's just agreeing. You get, it's like a triangle from your head to both hands. So you're coordinating this and you're locking it in and syncing things up. And so after fingers two and three, then two and four. So when. Now watch when I get up here. technique of my left hand, how it's like this, it barely moves. Economy of motion. I have trained my fingers over the years to stay close. That's why I'm still so fast on guitar. And so when you use fingers 3 and 4, the same thing again. Because a lot of times people will play that exercise literally. I mean, it's all over the place, but you have control. The mind can control. Now I control it. Okay. Joey controls it. But the point is this, that you can literally, after a while, bring those fingers together. See, all these little nuances are the difference between me never being hurt and someone, even myself, getting hurt. Playing because a repetitive motion. You do things the same way, you're on tour, or just freaky things happen. You know. Now, I use a clean sound. Sometimes I'll use overdrive. Why? You want to vary this because it's when you play. It's different than going. So anyway, after I finish all that, then I do the 4 notes per string. And I find that in my playing, I do a lot of chromatics. And I get that because of that 4 note per string exercise that I practice. It just lays real comfortable for me. And so I like it. And I'll use that in between fast riffs to make things kind of stagger and move around. So when I finish the 2-finger exercises, then I do the 4-finger exercise. Then I do this. This is my regime all the time, and I've showed this exact thing in Metal Mouth. The blues scale.